Welcome to today's very, very special concert. The Australian soprano Miriam Allan, and organist from Westminster Abbey, no, Westminster Cathedral, sorry, James Orford. How lucky we are. A very warm welcome to our audience here at St. Paul's, Knightsbridge, as well as our online audience in Australia and the UK. This is our first live concert in over a year in this most beautiful church. Of course, we know this very well. We've had many concerts here. With thanks to the Reverend Alan Gyle and the concert sponsors, the Thornton Foundation and Voyage Control. Today's concert is also a tribute to all the trust donors, local supporters, and all our young artists who've gotten us through this terrible pandemic. It has been a year since the first of the Tait Trust Tuesday concerts, which we launched to raise funds for the Tait Emergency Relief Fund. The past year has presented so many challenges to our Tait young artists. It's been really challenging. But the good news is how our donors helped us to lighten some of the pain, and also how we've been able to give many of our artists a platform through our concerts. For some, that was the only performance they had last year. Our bonanza came in July when the High Commissioner offered us the beautiful exhibition hall at Australia House to record a string of concerts to showcase our shattered artists. Then, in September, the High Commissioner once again gave us the exhibition hall to record a gala concert in honour of Maestro Richard Bonning's 90th birthday. The proceeds of this, which have been launched a new award in Richard's name. So we have been busy. As a result, I'm pleased to be able to announce that our funding increased by a staggering 55% compared to the previous year. We distribute a total of £84,000, or approximately $154,000 Aussie dollars, which we are so proud of. And thanks to our loyal donors over the past year, we've been able to increase our endowment fund, which we know is vital for the future. A special thank you to our Tait administrator, James Hancock, who's worked tirelessly for us during the past year. And to all of you who have supported our concerts or made a direct donation to our Tait friends, we are always there for us. And to 114 performers who donated 20% of their concert income to the Emergency Fund to help their colleagues. Together, we really made a difference. Lastly, I'm very excited to announce the first recipient of the Richard Bonning Award, young ballet dancer Liberty Grace. She joins us here today and is live in the audience. She's here today and live in the audience. Together with generous assistance from the Linbury Trust and David Norman, she will receive a substantial award to help her with the fees at the Royal Ballet School. We are so pleased to welcome her to the Tait family and will watch her progress with enormous interest. I'm now delighted to welcome His Excellency the Honourable George Brandis, who's kindly agreed to open the concert for us.
Well, thank you very much indeed, Isla, and good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. What a joy. What an absolute joy to be back enjoying a live performance again after all this time. I think it's 14 months since the last live performance that we enjoyed under the auspices of the Tait Memorial Trust. I want to begin by thanking all of you, the supporters and benefactors of the Tait Memorial Trust, who have kept the faith in this very, very difficult time. And Isla's just explained to us related to us some of the events that occurred online, some of them in the exhibition hall at Australia House during the difficult period of the pandemic. It has been such a difficult time for all forms of live performance. It has been such a difficult time for organisations such as this. And the commitment and the tenacity and the sense of optimism that was kept alive by the Tait Memorial Trust during this past difficult year, more than a year now, I think is frankly inspirational, as is Isla Baring. Now, Isla, since I've been the High Commissioner in London some 3 years now, I've come to know you, and I've become one of your greatest admirers. Isla founded the Tait Memorial Trust 28 years ago, nearly 29 years ago in 1992, with the generous thought of providing support, material support, for young Australian musicians, singers, dancers who come to this great city from Australia to pursue their dream of a career in music or in ballet, but need support, as all young artists do. And the loving embrace of the Tait Memorial Trust has made such a material difference to the lives of so many young Australians who have gone on to have splendid and brilliant careers, many of them splendid and brilliant international careers. Might I take the opportunity to offer my warmest congratulations to Liberty Grace on the award of the Richard Bonning Award. You'll be, I'm told, going to the upper school, the Royal Ballet School, in September. One of the finest ballet schools in the world. And heaven, it's just so exciting. I mean, heaven alone knows what awaits you in the years and decades to come. But to know that your fellow Australians and someone as generous as Isla and the trustees of the Tait Memorial Trust have helped, as have, of course, most importantly of all, your parents who are with you here today, to give you that opportunity. It's so exciting and we are so delighted for you. We're going to have a wonderful concert today. We are going to hear Miriam Allan, whom we last heard, or at least most of us last heard, singing as one of the ensemble at the funeral of His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh. She's going to be accompanied by James Orford, the principal organist of Westminster Cathedral. It will be a delightful hour or so of entertainment and song. But the occasion itself is such a delightful occasion and such an exciting occasion to celebrate once again in person the art form we love and the artists we love. Thank you.
And welcome to St Paul's Knightsbridge here in the heart of London. My name is obviously Miriam Allan, and with my colleague James Orford, we're delighted to be presenting this programme of works for soprano and organ. Soprano and organ is not the most logical of recital collaborations. Maybe not for most, but for me, it's utterly routine, for I've spent my entire life singing in churches, being accompanied by an organ. From the age of six, I was a chorister at Christchurch Cathedral, Newcastle, in New South Wales, Australia. There I was with my long hair, my love of ballet, and 23 boys. But I was welcomed, incredibly well-trained by Philip Matthias, and so a lot of the music you hear today either comes from that time or has been inspired by that time. We started with the most wonderful mashup of Bach's instantly recognizable first prelude in C major, but transposed with a melody added by Charles Gounod. So we're going to stay in France now for this next set of songs and trace the great lineage of Catholic French music from the late 19th and early 20th centuries. Fauré's Pie Jesu from his Requiem has to be one of his most loved and recognized works. His students included the wonderful Nadia Boulanger. Her piece, Lux Aeterna, May Light Perpetual Shine, is breathtaking in its perfect simplicity. Like Fauré, the great French organist Jean Langlais was a noted composer, and with sincere thanks to Marie-Louise Langlais, his widow, James and I are honored to present four works today, unpublished, for this recital, also taking Catholic texts like the Fauré and the Boulanger you'll hear before.
Thank you.
will now be published. The Anglican tradition is the core of my musical heart, and of course this Anglican heart grew up in Australia, specifically in Newcastle, singing in the cathedral, but when I was a little older, singing in St. James King Street in Sydney, where I met David Drury. His beautiful carol, What Child Is This?, links so well with the Stanford we're going to hear later, where Stanford also draws on a carol, the Advent carol, Veni Emmanuel. After David's piece is Andrew Anderson's I Gave My Lord an Apple. I've really enjoyed learning this beautiful work, and James and I are delighted to present it to you today. What child is this I laid to rest? One that is helpless sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. This is Christ the King. much like my own biography, we have to come back to England. James and I are so glad you could join us today. Thank you for inviting us into your homes. We can't tell you how delighted we are to see actual people in an actual building that we are also in. Thank you so much for supporting the Tait Memorial Trust and the fine work that they do. My thanks also to James Swanson and Voyage Control and the Thornton Foundation for sponsoring today's recital. There is no more idiomatic an Anglican composer than Charles Villiers Stanford. The music is unmistakably his, and it's marvelous. Here follow the six Bible songs, taking texts from the Psalms, Isaiah, and Ecclesiasticus. And they have the following wonderful names: the Song of Freedom, Song of Trust, Song of Hope, Song of Peace, Song of Battle, and Song of Wisdom, after which this program is named.
Thank you.
shall not die.